class teacher. Welcome to SSV IIT classes. Now we are discussing about 6th class compound angles. In previous class we discussed about the trigonometric ratios and their values, some more examples. There are 6 trigonometric ratios: sine theta and cos theta, which is known as cosine theta, and tan theta, which is known as tangent theta, and cot theta, which is known as cotangent theta, secant theta and cosecant theta. And we know the formulas for those trigonometric ratios. After that we have compound angle. What is a compound angle? If adding or subtracting two or more angles in a triangle is known as a compound angle. For example, the geometrical sums means a plus b comma a minus b, or a plus b minus c, and so on, are known as compound angles. Let us, we will find the value of a cos of a plus b, which is known as cos a cos b minus sin a sin b, which is the first theorem in our material. Then draw a unit circle with the center at origin. For example, this is the center of the circle, which is known as origin. It is x axis, it is y axis, its center is origin, and its radius is 1 unit. It is known as a unit circle. Let us, the point of intersection of the circle and x axis is known as P, and mark any two points on the first quadrant Q R. The distance OQ and also OR known as unit, 1 unit. And one more point S in fourth quadrant, same OS is equal to 1 unit, which are OP, OQ, OR, OS are 1 unit. And listen, let us, the inclination of the angle which is in anti-clockwise gives us positive sign, and clockwise gives us negative sign. Let us, I am taking POQ, angle is A, angle A, and QOR is known as angle B, and here POS will be taken as a in clockwise direction, its sign is negative. Numerically both the B angle B's are equal, but their signs are different. From the adjacent figure, observe, we want to find the A, B values with respect to the sine and the cos. Let us draw a perpendicular from Q to x axis, and R to x axis, and S to x axis, which are known as perpendiculars. So their intersection will be L, M, N. In triangle, observe, in triangle OQN, OQN, so which is known as here 90 degrees, then OQ is the hypotenuse, here inclination is angle A, then sin A is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, means QN by OQ. So already we know OQ value is 1, so QN by 1, that is sin A is equal to QN. What do you mean by QN? The position of the point Q is, listen, its distance from x axis gives us y coordinate, means QN. We want to find the cos A for same. Cos A in triangle OQN. Cos A is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, means which gives us ON by OQ. ON by OQ value already we know 1, means OP, OQ, OR, OS is equal to 1, because of it is a unit circle, its radius is 1. So cos A is equal to ON. Observe the point, the coordinates of Q gives us Listen, Qn sin A. Qn means distance from x-axis to point Q, and ON gives us distance from y-axis to point Q. Means the coordinates of Q are. The coordinates are Q. Cos A comma sin A. And we know this is the point P, coordinates of P, which is a unit circle 1 comma 0, and the distance of one unit y coordinate is 0. Then PQR, we want to find the R and S coordinates similarly. Here R coordinates in triangle ORL. ORL. Similarly, we will find sin A, sin B and cos B. Then the coordinates R, we will get cos B and sin B. And yes, the coordinates of we will find the derivative proof for this. So in triangle ORL, B inclination is B, then total angle will become ORL A plus B, means sine of A plus B is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, RL by OR. RL by OR. Then RL value we don't know, OR value equal to 1. So sin of A plus B is equal to RL by 1. It is equal to unit. Similarly, cos of A plus B is equal to cos of adjacent by hypotenuse, OL by OR. OL by OR, OR value 1, OL. So cos A plus B is equal to OL. OL means x coordinate, RL means y coordinate. The coordinates of R are, first of all, x coordinate OL. OL means cos A plus B comma sin A plus B. And the last one is S, the coordinates of S. Here we want to take the angle B, which is in clockwise direction, gives us negative side. Then in triangle OMS, sin B minus B, sin of minus B is equal to, observe here, opposite by hypotenuse, MS by OS, MS by OS, OS value 1, MS. Sin of minus theta minus sin theta minus sin B is equal to MS. Then find of finding of cos of minus B, that is equal to same, adjacent by hypotenuse, OM by OS. OM by OS. OS value 1. So cos of minus theta, cos B is equal to OM. Then the coordinates of S will be cos B comma minus sin B. These are the values of PQ, RS. From observe, here we have two triangles which are POQ. By joining this, we will get a triangle POR. In triangle POR, and one more triangle QOS. By joining these two, QOS and triangle QOS, which are congruent based on, listen, each and every side of the triangle equal to 1, and the inclination angle at vertex O, A plus B, upside, downside, A plus B. Numerically we are adding, not sides, A plus B, A plus B. So the sides which are opposite to the A plus B angle are equal. A plus B opposite side is PR, this A plus B opposite side is QS. So angle POR, angle POR is equal to angle QOS, angle QOS, which is known as A plus B. Means the sides which are opposite to the equal angles are equal, or corresponding sides are equal. So we can take PR is equal to QS, squaring on both sides. PR square is equal to QS square, which gives us the distance formula. Distance between P and R
Q and S. We know the coordinates of PQRS. By finding the values of PR square means the distance formula is square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Already we have PR square means we didn't get square root value. Except square root, we will get this value. PR square. PR square. This one x1 by 1, x2 by 2. X2 minus x1. Cos of a plus b. Cos of a plus b minus 1 whole square plus y2 minus y1. Sin of a plus b minus 0. Sin of a plus b minus 0 whole square is equal to RHS side QS square. QS square. So x2 minus x1. Cos b minus cos a whole square. Cos b minus cos a whole square plus y2 minus y1 minus sin b minus sin a whole square minus sin b minus sin a whole square. This expansion will become a minus b whole square form. So cos square of a plus b plus 1 a square b square minus 2ab 2 cos a plus b plus this one simply you can write as sine square of a plus b, that is equal to a minus b expansion cos square b plus cos square a minus 2 cos a cos b. Last one, we have total negative, by taking common it will become positive. Sin a plus sin b whole square form. Sin square a plus sin square b plus 2 sin a sin b. Observe, by simplifying it, cos square a plus b. Plus 1 minus 2 cos a plus b plus sin square theta will be written as 1 minus cos square theta. Sin square 1 minus cos square of a plus b is equal to, here we have observe cos square a sin square a, its value the first identity in trigonometry, cos square a plus sin square a value 1 and also cos square b sin square value 1 and plus 1. Here we have minus 2 cos a cos b plus 2 sin a sin b. Here plus cos square a plus b minus cos square a plus b will get cancelled. Plus 1 2. 2 minus 2 cos a plus b. That is equal to 1 plus 1 2. By taking minus 2 common it will become cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. By cancelling 2 on both sides, minus minus it goes cancel, then minus 2 cos of a plus b is equal to minus 2 cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Then 2 2 minus also cancel. Finally cos of a plus b is equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. This is the first identity in compound angles. By using this condition, we will prove one more identity. Thank you.